Hello everyone. Today, I stand here to talk about an invisible enemy that is slowly suffocating our planet, plastic pollution. It surrounds us, invades our homes, our bodies. But yet, many people still remain unaware of its devastating consequences. Plastic is everywhere. Look around you. Plastic is in your water bottles, shopping bags, food packaging, and even your clothes. Since the 1950s, over 8 billion tons of plastic has been produced, but only 9% of it has been recycled. The rest, it ends up in landfills, rivers, and oceans, where it will stay for hundreds of years, unable to digest by planet Earth. Plastic harms wildlife. Every year, over 1 million marine animals die from plastic waste. Sea turtles mistake plastic bags as jellyfish. Birds get tangled by plastic rings. Fish ingest microplastics. These tiny plastic particles enter the food chain and eventually our plates. Plastic harms human health. Scientists have found microplastics in our blood, our lungs, and even breast milk. Chemicals in plastic like BPA and phthalates are linked to cancer, infertility, and developmental problems. If we keep consuming plastic, we are poisoning ourselves. Economic costs are staggering. Cleaning up plastic costs billions yearly. Tourism suffers when beaches are polluted by plastic trash. Fisheries collapse as fish population declines. Plastic pollution isn't just an environmental problem, it's an economic disaster. So, what can we do? The good news, we can change this. First, refuse single-use plastic, like bottles, bags, and straws. Second, choose reusable alternatives, like metal straws and cloth bags. Third, support policies that ban harmful plastics. Fourth, recycle properly and demand better waste management. Now, scientists have developed biodegradable plastic that is degradable. This way, we can recycle and reuse plastic in a very good way. We can also use pyrolysis to turn plastic into low sulfur fuel. That's to heat the plastic in an oxygen-free environment. My family had stopped going out to eat because if we don't eat it all, we'll waste a lot of plastic packings. We also stopped using plastic bags. We take cloth bags wherever we go. When we go to the beach, we take a bag and start picking up trash along the way. If other people see us, they will start doing the same. In conclusion, plastic pollution isn't just someone else's problem. It's our problem. If we don't act now, future generations will inherit a planet drowning in plastic. But together, we can turn the tide. So let's start today, because the Earth won't wait. Thank you.